I'm Douglas Robinson. I'm a professor of wildlife science in the Fisheries and Wildlife Department at Oregon State, and I'm the director of the Oregon 2020 Birds Project. The Oregon 2020 Project is essentially a legacy science project. What we're trying to do is leave a benchmark in time that measures the number and locations of birds in the state of Oregon. And the idea is basically that we live in a really dynamic time in Earth's history. We know that we are at least partly responsible for changing the landscape and changing the climate. And we also know that birds respond to those kinds of changes. And so what we want to do is help future citizens measure exactly how birds have responded to those changes by leaving them a great legacy of data. So the idea is that they can come back and they can exactly repeat the work that we've done on birds, and they can look back with 20/20 hindsight, that's why the project is called that, and understand exactly how birds have changed over time in their numbers and where they live. There are lots of easy ways to volunteer for the Oregon 2020 Project. If you like to get out and explore the countryside, we have almost 3,000 different locations scattered around the state that are specifically picked to be counted for birds. And so you can go to our website, which is oregon2020.com, and you can find those locations. And essentially what you do is when you get into that location, you count birds like you would in your backyard, and then put those data into eBird.
Hi, my name is Tyler Hallman. I'm a PhD student in the Department of Fisheries and Wildlife at Oregon State University, and I'm a coordinator for Oregon 2020.
Hi, my name is Jenna Curtis. I'm a PhD student in the Department of Fisheries and Wildlife at Oregon State University, and I'm a project coordinator for the Oregon 2020 Project.
My name is Mike Ellis. I'm a master's student in the Department of Fisheries and Wildlife at Oregon State University, and I'm a volunteer for the Oregon 2020 Project.
My name's Allison Jackson, and I'm a PhD student in the Fisheries and Wildlife Department at Oregon State. And I am not a very good birder, but I'm hoping that these guys are going to teach me a little bit about it so that I can be a volunteer for Oregon 2020.
My name's Evan Jackson. I'm a master's student in the Departments of Forest Ecosystems and Society and Fisheries and Wildlife at Oregon State University, and I'm a volunteer for the Oregon 2020 Project.
I'm Amy Hallman, and I'm research faculty at Oregon State University, but I really enjoy viewing wildlife in my free time. I'd like to help count for Oregon 2020.
My name is Colleen Emery, and I'm a recent graduate from OSU in Natural Resources, and I heard about the Oregon 2020 Project, and I came prepared.
Really, all you need is just a pair of binoculars and a notebook. So, here we are. We've navigated to the hotspot that we identified online, and so we're at McFadden Marsh at Finley Refuge, one of my favorite places in the whole world. And so I want to tell you very quickly how you do a count. And so the most valuable kind of count to us is if you stand in one place within the hot spot and you do a timed count of birds. It can take 20, 30 minutes at a marsh like this. All you need to do is count and identify all the birds that are around. And when you get done, you know at the end time, and at the end of the day when you go home, you can log on to eBird and enter your count data, and there you have it. The project covers the whole state. It's a really big state, as you know, and so it's going to take several years in order to completely survey the state. Our goal is to finish the project by the year 2020. So we should have surveys conducted across the entire state, from the coast all the way to the Idaho border, all over the place. Now, bird blitzes are one of the best parts of the whole project, and those are basically weekend events where we invite birders, citizen scientists, to come and join us for a weekend of birding across counties in Oregon that have been particularly understudied. Probably the most overlooked and simplest contribution is to count birds in your yard. If you can sit on the back deck, have a cup of coffee, and spend 5, 10, 15 minutes just counting the birds that are in your own yard, and then put those data into eBird, that's the easiest contribution.